I came up here today to give you a demonstration, MnDOT, a demonstration of our asphalt repair technology. And because they didn't have a pothole present here in the parking lot, basically we created our own pothole by heating the base asphalt up and facilitated a repair of a water riser that was already in the parking lot that was damaged. It was surrounded by asphalt, so we heated that out of the way, repaired the riser, and then replaced the asphalt. Kind of like you would with a pothole, only this one had a water riser in the middle of it. This is primarily a winter-based technology, so what we're not trying to replace hot mix or hot plants that you normally would use. What we have here is the ability to heat not only the base material, but also to heat up the patch material during winter months. And what that does is allows the two to stick together, vulcanize together, and creates a permanent repair in the middle of the winter time. This is a commercial grade 915 megahertz transmitter, and the difference in that is the wavelength. So your household variety microwaves have a very short wavelength, and that's why a lot of people have tried this particular type of application with household variety power, but it just can't penetrate. So the 915 is industrial, so they use it a lot in cooking bacon and food products and all manner of industrial applications. What we've done that's different is we truck mounted it, which nobody's ever done before. So we have the only truck mounted 915 mobile microwave system that I know of in the world anyway. And then the other thing that's proprietary to us is the horn assembly and the way that we transmit the microwave to the ground. That's what's patentable for us, and that's our claim to fame. The other thing that we've done that makes us unique is that we were able to contain all the energy. So during the demonstration, I used a meter that showed that nobody in the audience was having any exposure to microwave energy. That's not only a requirement by the FCC, but it's one of the few, we're the few companies that have ever found ways to actually contain all that energy so that operators and people in the immediate area aren't exposed to any microwaves at all. The mix is 100% recycled, which we really like. We use what's known as RAP, recycled asphalt product, and then it's mixed with a proprietary emulsion that Cryos developed out of their labs in Minneapolis, and they've supplied the mix and the formulation of the mix. So it has, the other unique thing about this mix is it has magnetite, which is a plentiful mineral, Minnesota mineral, iron ore type mineral, and what that does is allows the microwaves to attract to the mix much more quickly and heat the mix, the repair mix, faster than they're heating the surrounding asphalt. So we wanted to make sure that our mix got really good and hot, but we didn't overheat the surrounding asphalt. So those chemistry type things have taken a little while to get through development. We went through extensive testing up in District 1 MnDOT last winter. University of Minnesota and NRRI, their offshoot up there, helped us quite a bit as far as developing the right mixes. But now those mixes are developed and are commercially available, as is our truck. This material has been tested after it's been, you know, microwaved and then compacted, and it has a tensile strength that's incredible. It has the ability to bond to other surfaces, which is very, very strong. And so the patch repairs that you'll see in the middle of the winter with this are stronger than you will find in the summertime using traditional asphalt.